Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of MLOps with MLflow. We are going to see how to work in MLflow with a model, a quantized model in format GGUF. Essentially, it's a continuation of one of the videos I did a couple of days ago where I transform the V3 mini 128K strat into different formats with Llama CPP. Now we are going to save this model in the model, sorry, in the tracking server, in a tracking server, MLflow, in an artifact repository, and then on we will later load it into a PY model in MLflow and do inference. This way I want to show you how not only you can work with libraries which are integrated natively with MLflow, also with something like here, which is a model we created because Llama CPP is not working natively with MLflow. Just we are going to create a custom PY or Python model, load it or save it into MLflow, and later retrieve it to do inference in theory in any place, just if we create correctly the environment. As usual, I have created a notebook that later on I will push to the repository. You will be able to download and how to say, replicate exactly the same that I'm doing here in the video. The first thing we are going to do is just install the libraries we need. Remember to install the Llama CPP Python client with support GPU. Then on, I mount my drive because I had the models in my drive in local. I'm uploading all the stuff I transferred a couple of days ago in the video. I upload this in model homemade. I already have three and still loading the model, so it's taking a while. I don't know what happened with my internet, but it's going really, really slow. But for now I have this 4K is a V3 mini 4K instruct. This is also quantified to 8 bit bytes. This is 128 quantified 8 byte, and still uploading. I think exactly. I had here the V3 smart 120 strat. This is brain float 16. I will later on push it to the Hugging Face hub to everybody be able to access to it. And I had still one being uploaded. Just to give you an idea, still uploading to Hugging Face for 2 days. I don't know, probably something connected with my computer. Okay, no cares. Later I will patch you as well the links to, or you can look in my user in Hugging Face. You will have all of them. As soon as I have it here in Hugging Face, I will log them into Hugging Face and you can access to them and download it into your local environment. In any case, I mount my drive, I connect to Databricks, just to lock the experiment, the models. This is for the previous video I recorded in Spanish. I load the environmental variables. I'm not going to explain again this because I explained it many times in different videos in the channel. You can take a look on those, how to work with Databricks and MLflow in Databricks. We are suppressing here some of the warnings. We are not interested in user warnings. We are going to remove as well the warnings, not only the user warnings, just to warning. Okay, and here we just import the libraries we need. By the way, I'm working in Colab Pro in an L4. Let me Where I have it? Yeah, well, I load it just here. So I import what I need. Everflow 2.14.1. This is the path to the GGUF file. I have it here again. I had already three, but I'm pointing to the fee 3 mini 128k instruct. Quanti size to 8 bytes in GUF format, and then I create now my class in a Python model, and then essentially what I'm doing is using the Llama class and importing here, and then the Llama is just pointing to the context active as a snapshot. This is the path where I put here. Later we will see the signature, and this I fix it the number of the tokens that we are going to produce, the number of threads, and the number of GPU layers. Remember, put everything. If you have a good GPU, put all the layers available on the model in the GPU, because it's going to speed up the process. You will see how quickly make inference this model. Build the prompt, essentially it's just take the template. Remember that it's a little bit special prompt, but well, not very complicated. Just you write it like this, and you send the instruction and put it here. And in the prediction, you just take a, remember, we make a video with the fee 128k instruct just to test it. And then we are creating a data frame. We just create with a row. And here we are just taking the input, which is a data frame. We take the first row, and then we pass it with the parameters temperature tokens to the model. The model is essentially the Llama model in GUF format, and then we pass the prompt, the temperature, the token, the stop sequence, and no echo. This is not include the prompt in the answer. Then we take just the output correctly, and we generate the response. We send it. Yes, we are checking here which versions we have. We create the model signature. It's exactly the same that we have here. Remember this, you have a video already in the channel that was with the original Microsoft fee mini 128k instruct, just the model with safe tensors downloaded from Hugging Face Hub. And then we just adapt this class to work with GGUF model. And then here, well, there is the tokenizer here. You probably know that in the GUS we don't have tokenizer, it's working differently. But well, finally we just adapt this. But the signature is exactly the same that we have here. This I did it on purpose just to show you that the format change, but not the way how we interact with the model. We are doing exactly the same. You can implement here other parameters in Llama class, in Llama CPP, Llama. You had exactly the same. You had temperature, top K, top P, all these parameters for a generative model. You have it as well. But I wanted to show you in purpose that we are using exactly the same parameters that we use with the original models in safe tensors in the original V3 models. So we use the same. We create an experiment. We don't have it. Well, we already have it because I already worked a couple of times with this, couple of tests. Now we do it again, and now we just simply serialize the model into MFlow. Check it out here. You probably hear me in some of the videos. I don't like this, but I just wanted to show you in before that you can create the environment with PIP requirements. The best, in my opinion, is to leave MFlow to detect what you have in your environment, because you here can miss something. I here just include the Llama CPP version, but probably something more is missing. In any case, in your environment, remove this and allow MFlow to do it, to infer directly what you had in your environment. Let's log it again. Now it's gonna take, you will see the model from a local repository, and you see here V3 mini 128K GUF is loading here, probably here again. Yeah, it's create a new experiment, 378 gigabytes, and then on you will see like here we have the artifacts, and then here you had everything you need to load the model in another environment. Check it out here, the model, Llama CPP, and in artifact you just simply have the GUF file. Now already created, this is the URL, is the CC3. One second. One second. Oops. Okay. CC3. Let's check if we had the model is already here. Exactly. CC3. And you see here, obviously, we don't have model metrics. We are not training, we just use the MFlow to save the model and have it ready to be downloaded anywhere. EML model, you can see here the path code, the input. Just compare with the previous one we uploaded there. So now we load the model. We just point to the model URI and runs, and then now we are downloading the model to our local environment. Again, the local environment has to have everything ready to work with the model. So meaning that you have to have Llama CPP and all the other libraries in the same version. It's not MFlow will try to adapt the model to what you have, and since you see that we are loading essentially the model in Llama CPP, it's a typical load in Llama CPP. And now, well, just simply with the load model, we are going to do the same that we did in previous videos, just to do some inference. We use loaded model, predict, we send the data frame, here we send a new temperature and some new tokens definition. We are here, look at the time, 08 seconds. And then on what is predicting my model. Yeah, CB is correct. And now we send this to the, with the other prompt. And it's taking 7 seconds. Yeah, it's taking a lot. Non-CV is correct as well. Why is taking so long? Usually take 1 second. Probably something, yeah. Yeah, here you have here. Take a look again. Shouldn't take too long. But okay. In any case, what I wanted to show you how this is working with MFlow. In the previous video, when I record this in Spanish, it was taking less than 1 second. I don't know what happened now. It's the problem of the direct, no? But okay. Try to in your local environment, and if you have some issues, just let me know in the comments. I will try to help you. But yeah, it's Again, I wanted just to show you how to you can save this on the on MSflow. Now we work with a GUF model. In the past, we work with scikit-learn, with PyTorch, with Prophet, with whatever transformers, with ML as a service like you had in Anthropic or OpenAI or Gemini. It doesn't matter. You just create a class like here. It's gonna be your Python class, and then here you say you see how you are going to access the model. In this case, we just load with the Llama class, and then once you have it, you make inference. That's simple than that. And then you need to have a load context. This is not mandatory unless that you need to do something special as we are doing here, and obviously you have to have a predict. This is mandatory predict, because every model that you are wrapping with a Python model, it has to have a different prediction mechanism. And okay, that's all. It was short. I try not to bore you, but well, it's very interesting how this works. It's very easy. Believe me, you, as I say in many videos before, MLflow is a library that definitely you are going to use if you try to productionize your models. It doesn't matter which technology you are using. It doesn't matter which cloud provider you are using. MLflow is gonna work there. And as I said many times, you need to know how to work with. Today is one of the references, especially for machine learning engineers, which need a tool like MLflow to help to standardize all these processes, to productionize and make available the models, regardless the type of models that you are working with, to the rest of the users, and make the and this is really making the life not it's never gonna be easy. Believe me, the life of a machine learning engineer is always hard, but it's better when you have a tool like MLflow close to you and you know how to work with. Again, thank you very much. Thank you for watching the video up to this point. Sorry for all my this speech. Many times I say many things. And again, if you like the video, just give me a like. You think that it's useful for your job, for your training, for whatever you are watching this video, just give me a like. Subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Share with your colleagues and friends just to help me to promote the YouTube channel, my YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Bye bye.